Hey everybody, welcome back to the MacWhisperer Academy. I'm Dylan Stewart. They call me the MacWhisperer. And if you're one of those people that is constantly afraid of getting scammed by an email, and you're wondering to yourself, is this email real or are they trying to hack me? Then this video was made just for you. Email scams are nothing new. They date back to the beginning of the internet and Nigerian princes that were going to give you all of their wealth. But those were the good old days, back when email scams were simple and obvious. As technology has improved, the hackers are out to find new and innovative ways to separate you from your money or your personal data. But in today's video, I'm going to share with you the five rules that I use to determine whether an email is legitimate or a complete scam. Let's jump right in and get started with rule number one. Rule number one, if it doesn't address you personally, and email addresses don't count as personally, then it's junk. Let's take a look. Here we've got an email from Smith & Associates. It's a last and final warning. Dear Dylan at themacwhisperer.com. Nope, that's not my name. That's my email address. Email addresses are not a way to address someone personally. Let's take a look at the next one here. PayPal's a legitimate company, and according to this email, it looks like I bought a Samsung TV for $600 and a MacBook Pro for $350. Okay, I'm already suspicious, but let's look past that. I mean, this could be real, right? PayPal could have charged me. Let's see who they addressed it to. Oh, dear user. My name's not user. My name is Dylan. PayPal knows my name. This is junk. Let's take a look at the next one. This one is a subscription for McAfee. Let's take a look at how they address me. Dear subscriber. Still not my name. It's important for you to understand that rule number one will eliminate 75% of the junk email because they don't know who you are. They might know your email address, but they don't know your name. And that's how you know it's junk. That's rule number one. If it doesn't address you personally, then it's junk. Now let's move on to rule number two. Rule number two. If the email doesn't come from an email address that's associated with the company that's supposed to be sending you the email, then it's junk. So let's take a look at this email. We've got an email from PayPal here and it's addressed to me personally. It says, Dear Dylan Stewart. So I'm already thinking maybe it's real, but as I look at it, it's a $530 charge, including Bitcoin that I don't remember making. Let's see who sent this. To find out who sent an email, go up to the top where you see the from name and click the little arrow to the right side. It'll open up and tell you the actual email address. This is sgwdvxe266@gmail.com? Really? I don't think PayPal is going to use a Gmail address to send out an invoice. It's junk, right? Let's take a look at the next one. This one also pretends to be from PayPal. There are certain companies that get used frequently in emails because they're common companies that people are already a little confused by. One of them is PayPal, one of them is Best Buy or Geek Squad, one of them is McAfee, one of them is Norton. You're gonna see examples from all these companies as we go through. The more popular a company is, the more suspicious I am of their emails. So as I look at this one here, it looks like it's being sent by me? That makes no sense. Let's see who it's really from. Oh, npauthanson9@gmail.com. Remember, you can get a free Gmail address in about 30 seconds. So as soon as you see a Gmail address from a supposed company, it's junk. Look right past it. Let's see the next one here. Now here's an email from Apple. I get a lot of emails from Apple, but this one doesn't really look right. First off, it still doesn't address me by name, but I'm gonna look past that because it's Apple, and you know, maybe it's just a quick invoice. And as I look down, 12 terabytes of iCloud space for $1,500. Now, I already know this is junk because Apple doesn't offer an iCloud storage space of 12 terabytes. It's just not what they do. But let's just pretend for a moment that I'm fooled by it. Let's see what email address Apple is using. It should be something at apple.com, right? Let's take a look. Nope, Gmail. As soon as you see that it's a Gmail address, you should immediately go, this is not legitimate. Apple would use an Apple address. Amazon would use an Amazon address. PayPal or GoDaddy or any of these companies, they have their own email services. They'll use them. They won't be using Gmail. So that's rule number two. If the from address doesn't match the company that's supposed to be sending you the email, it's junk. Now, let's talk about rule number three. Rule number three, does it look real? If it doesn't look real, it's probably junk. Now let's take a look at a couple of these examples to see what we're talking about. Does it look real? As I look at this one from Geek Squad, now we're gonna ignore the fact that it's not addressed to me personally, and we're gonna ignore the fact that it's clearly being sent from the wrong address. So I already know it's junk, but look at the Geek Squad logo. That doesn't look anything like the Geek Squad logo. I don't even think it's the right colors. If it looks a little off, it's probably junk. Let's keep looking. Here's one for Norton. Norton email scams come fast and furious. I've got 50 or 60 of them in this email box alone. But if you look at the logo, it looks squashed and crunched. Doesn't look like somebody sent this out professionally, because somebody didn't. This is junk, and it's obvious when you look at the image. Here's one from Geek Squad. Now, let's go back to this one. There's Geek Squad. And here's Geek Squad. The logos look completely different. At least this logo looks more or less legitimate. But the thing that throws me off here is this weird green box that says invoice. That's a little unusual. That doesn't look very well designed, right? Also, look at the Best Buy and the Geek Squad logos down here. They're a little transparent. It's not real. If it doesn't look real, it's probably not real. Keep your eyes open for that. How about this one? Look at how squashed that Geek Squad logo is. They used the right logo, but they compressed it. Why? Because they aren't Geek Squad. They took that off the Geek Squad website. That's rule number three for you. If it doesn't look right, if the logo's funny, if the logo's not accurate, if images are squashed or stretched, if it looks super pixelated, it's junk. Get rid of it. Now let's talk about rule number four. Rule number four. If the grammar is terrible, it's probably junk. Let's take a look at a couple of terrible grammar emails here. Dear customer, we are glad to serve you as our registered customer. We have the premium security services ready for installation as per our connect with you. What? As per our connect with you? I was kind of with you up till then. I mean, you had a decent logo. It looked kind of real. As per our connect with you, period. Not even a full sentence. That's junk. Let's see the next one here. Thank you for using PayPal. Your account has been charged with blah, 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 and will be going to deduct from your account within 24 hours. And will be going to deduct? All right. Last one. We would like to inform you your free subscription of McAfee Total Protection getting expire today. Getting expire today? Do we need to say anything more? Rule number four, if the grammar is funky, the email's junky. Let's move on to the last step. Rule number five, does it seem suspicious? Rule number five is more of a guideline than a rule. This is a place where you're going to have to use your best judgment and your common sense to determine if it seems too good to be true, because then it probably is, right? Let's take a look at a couple of these examples here. In this email, David Cotton has emailed me in good faith. He's got a deceased client with a lot of money, and he'd like to give me that money. Scam anyone? I mean, that can't possibly be real. People don't just email you and give you money, right? Right? Let's look at the next one. I'm glad this one came up. I really want to talk about this one for a moment. I see this all the time. Clients email me this regularly and say, is this real? What is it? Well, this is an email purporting to be from someone who has hacked into your computer and they've seen your camera and they know what you do in front of it. A lot of people get scared. But regardless, this is junk. First off, doesn't address me personally. Now, it does look like it's coming from my email address. And if I click up here, it's going to appear to be Dylan@themacwhisperer.com, which is my email address. And he says he's sending it from my email address. One of the things that makes this email suspicious to me is that I've seen it before. I'm going to show you another one that looks exactly like this from somebody else. You have an outstanding payment. Unfortunately, there are some bad news for you. This is how they talk, and they're working on scare tactics. They're going to talk about a Bitcoin wallet somewhere in there. They're going to say, don't bother replying. They're going to say the fact that they emailed it from your address is proof that they're in your computer. It's all nonsense. It's all cookie cutter. You can easily make an email address look like it's coming from somebody else without any effort. I want to be really clear here. This is a super common cookie cutter email that I have personally seen hundreds and hundreds of times, and it has never once been real. So take it from me. If you get this message, it's junk. A lot of people will ask me, why do people send these kind of scams and these kind of emails? And what I want you to understand is it costs nothing to send an email, which means it costs nothing to send a billion emails. And if it costs nothing, it only takes one dodo to click a link and send the person Bitcoin money for it to become a profitable enterprise. Don't be that dodo. Be smart. Use common sense. If it feels suspicious, it's probably junk. So that's the 5 simple rules to keep you from getting scammed by email. And if you haven't subscribed to my channel yet, take a moment. Hit that subscribe button and that notify bell so you never miss out whenever I drop a new video. I'm Dylan Stewart. They call me the Mac Whisperer. It's my passion and profession to help people get more things done in less time and with less effort than they ever thought possible. With that being said, I'll see you next time.